Hey everybody, it's Erica. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back. So today I am doing a very hurried to get ready review of the Billy wrap dress from Ragamuffin Patterns. I meant to do this review like 2 weeks ago, and then the West Coast caught on fire, and it's literally been so hard to breathe here that I haven't been able to really do much. But it's a little better today. It's been raining. And the dress is on sale for $7 right now. So I thought, I've made two, I'm in love with them, I'm going to go ahead and review the dress for you guys real fast. Now, I am an affiliate for Ragamuffin, so I'll put a link below of my affiliate link to the dress. I get a little bit of money back if you guys buy the pattern. However, I want you to go check out the dress, and if you use the link, great, and if you don't, that's fine. It's just a cool dress. So it's a wrap dress. Will I be able to show you guys? Oh no, come on. Come on, less glare. Less glare. Okay, so it's got, oh good. It's a PDF pattern, and it's fighting me. Okay, so it has got a tulip skirt, an A-line skirt, and a straight skirt, like a pencil skirt. It's got multiple sleeve options, including bishop sleeves, standard sleeves, tulip-like envelope-style sleeves. It's got a mock wrap option, a faux wrap option, like a faux wrap where it doesn't wrap at all, fully wrap, and then a partial wrap option. It has multiple lengths. You can make it a shirt. You can make it a dress. You can make it all different things. There's a collar. There is a line so that you can actually add a circle skirt to it, which is what I did for this first version. So that's really cool. So I'm just going to stand up and I'll show you the first one I made, and then I'll show you the second one I did. So I did some modifications for both of my versions. This is the first one. This is from a double brushed poly. Sadly, the dress comes, I'll just stand on a chair. Hope I don't fall over. Okay. Ooh, here we go. Okay. So the dress comes a few inches above, below my knee. The both dresses are midi length dresses because that is my preferred length. So I didn't have much of this fabric. I had like 2 yards of this fabric to try to get the dress out of. So I did the faux wrap. So these sides are actually sewn together so it doesn't wrap around. And then I cut it off at the bodice point and sewed a half circle skirt to the bottom to try to save fabric. It worked really well. This is the plain sleeve, that's the short sleeve, t-shirt sleeve length. I added a band to mine. The dress is actually finished from the pattern by just turning it under half an inch and top stitching it down. That works really well for the version that you do with the collar because it has a facing on the inside of the collar. And so the turned in band looked really good. But I personally love the way a wrap dress looks with the little, you know, the little band on the neck. So that's what I did. And all I did to do that was I laid out the dress flat when I'd sewn the shoulder seams together and measured that and then cut a band that was like 2 inches high and then like 85% of what that measurement was. So that was my first one. Totally loved it. Love the fit in the back. Love everything about this. So then I thought I'd make a second one. So I'm just going to throw my second one on. Also, this is double brushed poly from Amazon, but I think it was actually from fabric.com through Amazon. And it's this really pretty red with these roses. So I loved that. I'm going to change really dress number two. This is the second one I made with the pattern. I did the banded collar again where I went through and did the neck band. This is the tulip sleeve. So it's actually, see, it's a doubled sleeve. Isn't that cute? So the sleeve is completely separate. It's only sewn together at the sleeve cap. I thought that was really a cute feature. This one, I didn't even think about it, and I went ahead and did my back neck adjustment that I do to make my neck sit higher because I have a sway back and I really didn't need to. So I need to remember on this pattern, I don't need to do that. Let me stand on the chair and show you. It's another faux wrap. And this one has the A-line skirt that comes with the pattern at the T length, like midi length. Now, I did do one change to this. When I was cutting it out, I realized that my natural waist was not in the same place as the pattern's waist. And because I like a waist seam anyway, what I did was I traced out the bodice and then I traced the A-line skirt piece and just put in a waist seam. So I sewed I traced the A-line skirt. Let's see if I can show you just what it would look like. So it made sense without showing you too much of the directions, which are excellent. So like the pattern piece, it kind of looks like that when it's not a wrap. So I just traced it, the A-line skirt part, and then sewed the A-line skirt to the top. So that's what I did. And I feel like I got a really cute dress. This fabric is also, like I said, from fabric.com, and I think it was on a really good sale. Do you love those little sleeves? I love them. I really want to try, I've got plans for two more Billies. I'm not sure when they're going to happen. One is definitely happening before Halloween, because it's going to be the bishop sleeve, and it's going to actually have the collar, but I can't tell you any more about that. And then I do have one, like, in some kind of DTY, like, really springy kind of fabric that I'll probably make later in the year. But anyway, so that is the Billy wrap dress. It's $7 right now at Ragamuffin. I will put an affiliate link down below if you want to use it, or you can just go and not use the link. I don't care. Just check out the dress because it's really cute. It's really easy. I would say an advanced beginner can make this dress. It's so easy to just make the faux wrap bodice and slap a half circle skirt or a full circle skirt on it and get a really 50s look. I feel like the more A-line one can look a little bit more 30s, 40s. And then if you do the one with the collar and the full wrap, it looks like a Diane von Furstenberg 70s wrap dress, which is kind of the way I'm going for the next time I make one. So multiple eras. This would totally work. I've used this for the vintage dress so long now, twice, because with the right fabric and the right styling, this could have a very vintage effect. Wrap dresses have been around since the early 1910s, like 1910s. Not this type of wrap dress, but a wrap bodice. So it is a style that never goes out of style and looks good on a lot of different people. It will hide things that you might consider flaws or imperfections and smooth over your curves, but it will also create curves where you don't really have them. I am not the curviest person, but I feel like a wrap dress creates that illusion. So definitely give it a try. If you've never sewn a wrap dress before, this one is probably one of my favorites. All right, see you guys next time. Bye!